Hi, welcome to the Semantics Lecture Light on Composition. If you recall, a composition, along with truth conditions, form the two fundamental concepts that are the backbone of semantics. And the reason is pretty straightforward. Right, with truth conditions, we understand the meanings of morphemes. Right? Let's say the word turnip is a single morpheme, it has a meaning, and even if we're not 100% sure what a turnip is, or what properties go into making a turnip, we know what its truth conditions are. We know what something needs to be a turnip. It needs to be a turnip, for one thing. Same for large and so forth. Now, this sentence has the truth conditions as well. But where did those truth conditions come from? Well, under the principle of compositionality, the truth conditions of the entire sentence comes from the truth conditions of the parts. And so one thing that we need to understand as semanticists is the mechanisms by which these meanings combine. We can tell that large and turnips go together. There's a difference between large turnips and turnips, truth conditionally. And so we can build a meaning out of those. And so what we want to understand is how those meanings combine. The same for to and then eat and so forth. Now, the principle of compositionality can kind of work two ways. The first is that it allows us to understand how expressions differ from each other. So if I change the word turnips and replaced it with rutabagas, right, we have a new sentence with new truth conditions. I'll eat two large rutabagas. But by the principle of compositionality, the meaning of the whole will change only with respect to what has been changed. So everything else will be the same, meaning-wise, except instead of turnips, we have rutabagas. And the truth conditions will change only with respect to that difference. If we change the auxiliary from will to may, right, I may eat two large rutabagas. Now, the part about me eating two large rutabagas is the same. But what's different now is that our certitude about whether this is going to happen or not. And that's the only difference that has changed. And so each change changes the sentence a little bit, and we get a new proposition. So in that sense, composition allows us to understand how these things differ, and then we can use those differences to figure out what these morphemes mean, which is really important for the more abstract ones like may. Children also use that mechanism under what's called semantic bootstrapping, where they understand, you know, I will eat too large something, and they hear this new word, turnip, and you know, based on the other, you know, the meanings of the rest of the sentence, it helps them figure out what turnips are. So we have that sense of composition, where we can break things down. Composition also allows us to build things up. Right? Language is an infinite process. It is a discrete combinatorial system. Or in Humboldt's words, it allows us to make infinite measures out of finite means. That is to say, we have a limited lexicon, but as you know, the syntax allows us to build an infinite number of structures based on those parts. But if each of those parts has a meaning, and the meanings combine, well, it stands to reason as well that there is an infinite number of possible meanings that can be constructed. And Donald Davidson went into this at length and discussed how this fact is what makes the truth conditions useful, right? Knowing that a turnip is something that's a turnip doesn't really help us a whole lot when we're trying to understand how the meaning of language works. It's almost obvious, right? But understanding how the meaning of turnips combines with these other things to make an infinite number of meanings, that will allow us a lot of power, of analytical power. Because now we don't have to know exactly what a turnip is. Now we can just figure out, well, how does turnip combine with large to create large turnip? And how does that combine with two to create two large terms, and so forth? Right. So, So compositionality allows us to see complex expressions and break them down, and it allows us as speakers to create an infinite number of meaningful expressions. And in that, we have one of the fundamental and powerful building blocks.